Hi, my loves, and welcome to my channel. My name is Erica. This is Gypsy Cowgirl Tarot. I am a psychic medium, oracle, and a prophetess, you guys. So what that means is I use the cards for visuals and to connect, but they're not needed, right? Because I channel and read energy. You guys have seen the title of the reading, so you know why you're here, all right? Those of you guys, this is your first time finding this channel. Welcome, my loves. This is a high vibe tribe, pillar of light channel, okay? We are star seeds, light warriors, all the things, right? This is a message today of, the message was very clear, and I heard, as I was like asking spirit for the channeled message for this reading, right outside just now, I heard it's time to fly. And I looked up, and right as I looked up, there was beautiful birds flying over. Okay. So, you know, if you are new here, those of you guys who are returning and you guys have been a part of the Gypsy tribe, right? Like, you guys know this is how I get like my messages and how I receive. I always receive and then I come in, I channel, right? Right as I looked up a second ago, it was 111. And I'm hearing new beginnings. Okay, so it is that, but it's time to fly. It's time to ascend. It's time to soar. It's time to, I'm hearing, utilize your high perspectives. So many of you guys have been ascending. You can see life from a higher view now, a higher perspective. A lot of you guys are very, you know, psychic, clairvoyant, prophetic, like all of that, right? You tap into higher dimensions, right? To the higher dimensions, to the, you can see through the veil. You, are very aware that you're a huge part of lifting the veil in that regard, right? Ascending this earth, like all the things, right? You have a lot of changes coming into your life at this time. 222 as I look back up again, okay? Because you guys, like when I'm channeling facing forward like this way. By the way, my loves, how do you like my new little Halloween setup? I love, love, love my little purple Halloween tree. And it actually has like all these little purple spiders, like on it. I'm absolutely obsessed. And then I have this little like Halloween, like string of lights. It's so cute. So it's like my favorite holiday. I mean, I love, you know, Christmas as well, but Halloween, it's like, duh, right? Plus I'm an October baby, so it's just my thing. Even though, you know, Halloween is Scorpio season, I'm Libra, but it's all in the same month, so, right? Anyways, I just keep hearing that Nicki Minaj song, I Came to Win, I Came to Fly, I Came to Conquer, I Came to, right, or whatever. I came to win, to survive, to conquer, to thrive, right? And fly, right? So I'm hearing that song, okay? And it's really powerful that I'm receiving that, like now actually, because I channeled that. That's what I was channeled, was it's time to fly. So it's time to conquer. It's your winning season. It's your number numero uno most magical season yet. It's the time that you receive everything that you have been healing and working and manifesting towards, right? Like all the things. Let me get one more shuffle and then I'm gonna pull some cards. So you're being called to step up. This one wants to come out. Lost in space, needing direction, 36. This could be someone's age. Very beautiful card, right? Needing direction and then opportunity. Okay. So this actually lines up perfectly, right, with my message. It's time to fly. I came to win. I came to rise. I came to conquer. I came to whatever it is that the verse is, however it goes, right? Like, I know I'm not saying it right, but it's basically like all of that, right? She's holding the whole world in her hands and her crown chakra is completely lit up. She's very connected in this moment. Again, I started this off by saying, like, it's like that bird's eye view where you have that very high perspective. You've had the high, you've had the shift. You've been ascending. You're seeing things in a very different light at this time, right? But this is literally her viewing her world from a higher perspective. Like, she's the one holding it, right? Like, it is that. This is a lot of solar plexus energy with all this yellow. It's a lot of solar energy, you know. Some of you guys, you might be Libras. This might be your season right now, right? Happy birthday, my loves, if it is. Because I am getting that solar return energy. Okay, so that solar return energy. So I'm definitely getting that for sure, for sure. So happy birthday to whoever's maybe birthday is even right today. Whenever you see this, or whenever this finds you, right? You feel like you've been needing direction, like in a lot of ways for some of you guys, right? Like, I'm not sure which way I want to go. I'm not sure which way to, you know, take my gifts, or I'm not sure which way to share my light, or I'm not sure which way to do this or that or whatever, right? This is that, like, call up to the heavens, call up to your angels, call up to your guides. They will help. They will assist, right? Here we go. Stranger and curiosity. Okay. Sorry, little spiders. All right, so 53 just came out. All right, so that breaks down to an 8. This one, 36, breaks down to a 9. You have 8 and 9. Beautiful. Okay, that breaks down to 17. All right, which breaks down to another 8. So you guys are getting a lot of like 8, 8, 8, 8, things like that. That's Spirit's way of letting you know that, first of all, if you guys are seeing a lot of 8, 8, okay, like that kind of thing, it is that you're, you know, if you are in a, like a twin flame separation, whatever, right? 727 also, I just looked up in the timestamp with 727. So there's something about that angel number, that I will look up in a moment, with my angel number book right here. But, for me, it's that mirroring type of aspect, right? So I'm channeling very heavily, right? And that obviously this is a very intense time for union, for twin flames and all that, even though this is not a twin flame reading, I'll be recording that next. But it's just coming through. So it's just another confirmation. It's also about your abundance, your divine inheritance. And literally, you can't make it up. Right as I look up again at the timestamp, it was 8 minutes even. So as I'm speaking of the eights and 8, 8, I got stopped on the 8 minute mark, okay? Some of you guys, this is your call. You've been kind of allowing your life just to like go wander, you know? Maybe you make plans, I'll do this in, you know, in 6 months from now, I'll do that, right? Like, it's always like another day, another time, all, you know? It's always like that, right? But this is that needing direction. It's like a wake-up call. It's time. Curiosity. I feel like, one, this is people around you, like, that are very curious about you. I feel like this is someone in particular, maybe a masculine, again, that kind of, like, divine masculine energy coming through, who is very curious. But I feel like, more than anything, this is you guys kind of reflecting. This is you guys that have been in a mode of, you know, just reflection, going within and thinking. And maybe some of you guys have felt a little lost in space. You know, maybe you're feeling a little spacey, like at this moment. Maybe you've been feeling a little spacey just in general over the recent past. You know, we've been having a lot of cosmic, you know, shifts, events, planets going retrograde, coming out of retrograde. We're in a very, you know, very intense time. We just had the 10-10 portal, right? We just had this beautiful full moon in Aries that brings forth a lot of fire and passion and action. So that's exactly what I feel like this message ties into, that needing direction. It's like, you know, look at moving out of stagnation. So this is definitely that, like I said, a wake-up call. It really is that. If you've been feeling like your life is not moving in any direction in particular, or it's like, you know what I mean? It's moving out of stagnation, because that is devil energy. That is karmic energy. You know, when we're ascending, that's what it is, right? Ascending, it's that expansive energy, expanding your consciousness, expanding your life, expanding your dreams, your resources, your finances, your health, your everything, right? So that's what this is. So again, it's time to fly. It is time to fly, and flying is super tied to, right? Like rising above, ascension, soaring with the heavens, spreading your wings and flying, you know, trying new things, like doing all that, right? This crown chakra keeps like really pulling me in. If you guys have been here, you guys know that I've been channeling like a lot about the crown chakra and the connection that we're, you know, that everyone's receiving, especially like, you know, all of us, but the divine masculine too. And the third eye and the heart, right? But this right here is the crown, and it's telling me that it's like you're super connected. So you're seeing things very differently, very clearly. Okay. And, you know, maybe you're just needing a little direction. Ask spirit for signs, right? Like tap into that intuition, things of that nature, right? But it's like whatever makes you happy. What are you passionate about, right? What fuels you, like what fuels your soul? What lights you up, right? And then Herald of Change, the Horseman, card number 30. Hey, horses can be significant here in one way or the next. The Horseman, 30. This could be someone's, maybe the date that you're, you know, your birth date, born on the 30th or the 15th, right? This could be an age, but it's also like breaks down to a 3 with the 0 amplifying it. So for me, this is about like unity, all right? You are coming, there's a lot of change happening in your life, and it's bringing you more into like your true whole self, wholeness, oneness. It's a great time of change, divine change. And this right here is that confirmation, Herald of Change. Very beautiful. Okay. Some of you guys are being called to step away from situations. All right. This is the Rider. So I feel like it's movement, moving away from something, even breaking free. The Dust Devil, moving out of stagnation. It could just be this, breaking free out of a stagnant energy. Beloved, radical acceptance. Beautiful. So number 2, which speaks of, divine union. So definitely divine masculine energy coming through, right? As I'm also speaking about breaking free, right? This is definitely about the DM also coming through again very heavily and letting you know that they are breaking free. There's something about breaking free. Beloved, radical acceptance, empty will, time to replenish. Yeah. So those of you guys who may be feeling, you know, very depleted of, you know, energy maybe right now, you know, we've been dealing with a lot of crazy shifts and solar flares and, you know, all these things, right? So there's a lot of heavy energy, dense energy. I just talked about this in my Instagram story last night. You guys can follow me there at Gypsy Cowgirl Tarot. Make sure it's the right account, you guys. Right? Yeah. And also, you guys, my loves, like, please, like, don't. There was a scammer in the comment section now. Okay. They're showing up in the comment section. Okay. All my videos. And they leave comments under your comments, and they are trying to solicit business and readings, and they have a WhatsApp or whatever, and I don't even have a WhatsApp, like at all, you guys. Plus, I would never even comment and say that, so you guys know this, right? So don't get duped, right? And it looks just like my thing. It says Gypsy Capital Tarot, and then it has my little thumbnail, right? But it's not me. And you could probably tell even by the way that they talk, because if you know me, you know how I talk and I speak, right? So anyways, it's okay. Let them, karma is karma, and you can't run from it ever, right? So they will get, it'll come back, right? It'll come back. What's really sad is that it's like cursing generations. Okay. So what I'm getting here is like spirit wants me to call you beloved. It's like they really want me to channel that right now and speak to you in this manner. 1515 on the timestamp, 6:6. My beautiful beloved, please accept and love yourself in this moment as you are, entirely and completely. Know that you are going through great change, great transformation, great upgrades, learning to value yourself more, love yourself more, hold yourself in a very high regard, sending love outwards. You are being rewarded. You're being blessed for taking this time to heal, to grow, to get to know yourself, to love yourself. Your beloved, beloved, your true twin flame, your true divine counterpart, past life soulmate, however this connection shows up for you. They are radically accepting their own ascension and growth, okay? And this is bringing forth union. But spirit, so that's that. They also want you to empty your, or to fill your reserves. It's like your well is empty, or you feel maybe empty, or you know what I mean? And I feel like that's what it is. This is a time to replenish. You know what I mean? So again, moving out of stagnation, herald of change, time to replenish, right? We had the summer, we had, right? And we are, this is just a time of great change, right? So however that looks for you, right? But some of you guys, you know, obviously if you're feeling like it's been, there's been a lot of stagnation in your life or in your, like in having direction in your life or making a plan or you know, maybe stagnation within like your abundance or your finances, you know? It's for some of you guys, maybe, blockages, right? Like spirit has created blockages because there's lessons that need to be learned before they will be unblocked. Like that kind of a thing, is what I'm getting. So, because again, the dust devil is like the devil energy. So again, that would be karmic. That would be karmic bondage. And, the divine will do that, right? The universe will do that. If you are, it's like you just go under judgment for with your finances, you know, and things of that nature until you learn the lesson, and then the blockage is, you know, it's whatever, you know what I mean? But that's how energy works. So let's see here. The drifter, experiencing life as it comes. Okay. I'm hearing Jimi Hendrix, drifting. If you guys ever heard, he says, drifting on a sea of forgotten teardrops or something like that, right? On a lifeboat, right? Sailing for your love, right? So someone is sailing towards you, literally, like they're sailing towards you. Wow, I haven't heard that song probably since I was like, I don't know, you guys, like 20 years old, maybe. I don't know, even maybe before that, okay? It's been a long time. It's almost 20 years ago, right? Experiencing life as it comes. You've done a great job, thank you, Spirit, at experiencing life as it comes. You've done a great job of radically loving through all of your hardship and pain. You've done a great job. You have the Wheel of Fortune, Fortune's Wheel. Card number 23 breaks down to a 5. This is about change, going in new directions, moving out of stagnation, following your curiosities and your bright ideas or manifestations that you want to see through and that you want to come to fruition, right? All of it. Luck and the right timing. See, you're surrounded by beautiful energy, right? So surrender. Ego sublimination, vanishing mirror, 58, and then 48. These go together for sure. And then this goes in reverse. Okay. So I'm getting kind of split energy here. So some of you, my loves, who are tuned in here, you are at a place in your life where you are experiencing great change, and it's all backed up with this Wheel of Fortune energy, the fortune's wheel. It is luck. It is destiny. It is serendipitous stuff. It is expansion. It is divine timing, right timing. It's everything. It's magic. It's, I'm hearing these magic moments, right? Dun, right? Okay. So I'm getting that. All right. Because you have gone into ego sublimination, ego death. All right. You can see through the ego very easily at this time. You can see through other people's egos. You can see, right? Because you conquered your own. You went within. You did all the things. Ego death, right? Sky dancer, surrender. You're dancing through life at this point. Whose reading was it that I did? Was it yesterday? And they had that energy, dancing through life. Cancer. It was Cancer. Okay, so you could be a Cancer, dealing with the Cancer. I don't know. I have Cancer in your chart. It doesn't matter. It's just like it's that moon energy. It's that very deep energy, subconscious. It's psychic. It's very emotional. So it's like you've connected because you surrendered. You've connected to, you know, the higher dimensions. You're tapping into all of that, right? You're connecting to all your oversouls, right? You're going all the way up for some of you guys, right? Connecting to a 12th dimension at this point, like super easily, right? It's like crazy what I'm seeing and feeling. And it's and this right here, again, look at moon, the moon energy, that Cancerian energy. I just noticed that. But the divine is saying you beautifully surrendered. So this is about you fully receiving blessings, okay? Now, the other energy that I'm getting, okay, I said it was split, is, and that is your change, all right? And also you have a lot of people curious about you, or curious about, you know, maybe they want to, you know, pursue you, date you, court you. Maybe there's people that are like interested in being like your friend, like they want to create friendships with you, you know. Maybe, you know, it'd be, you know, hey, you know, random direct message, like I think it would be fun, like would you like to grab a cup of coffee sometime or something like that, right? Like, but platonic, you guys, like if you're a feminine, okay, like it would be like maybe like another feminine, right? Who's just been following you or something, and maybe just thinks you're motivational or inspirational, right? It doesn't matter what you do for a living, or, you know, it's about you and your energy and maybe the stuff you post and things like that, right? So that's just an example. But anyways, so the other energy that I got here was that some of you guys are feeling that you have been lost in space. You feel like maybe you've been spinning in circles, not sure which way to go, which direction to go in life, right? You've started, you are ascending, you've gone through an awakening, you are, you know, connected with your crown and to the divine and all that, right? But there's still a great amount of confusion and not sure where to go and how to move forward in certain areas, or, you know, things of that nature. Okay. So you would be the ones who've been needing direction. Okay. And you've been needing direction because you weren't sure how to move out of stagnation. Okay. The dust devil. Okay. So you've been in some kind of, you know, there's karmic lessons here. Maybe you've been in a karmic, you know, bondage with a romantic partner. This could just be karmic bondage with your own self, where you're keeping yourself in stagnation and stuck and not expanding, even though you know you need to. It's things like that, right? Very self-sabotage energy, which the devil can be for sure. And that's what we have the empty well for as well, is time to replenish. So it is time to start creating plans and setting intentions, like real goals. And, you know, I'm hearing eye on the prize, you know, it's time for you to fly in that way. Okay. To replenish your life, replenish yourself, replenish your self-love and your self-worth, and replenish your finances, and replenish your, you know, your spiritual abundance and just everything. You know, I have no idea. It's different for everyone, but that's what I get, right? It's time to radically accept that you've kept yourself stuck in one way or the next, okay? This right here is, you know, it's balance and, you know, all these things, right? Like the twos, it's very important, very divine. But this for me is also right partnership. So I do feel that for the ones that I'm channeling this stagnant kind of energy with the dust devil and, you know, all that, it's you have this beautiful divine counterpart, divine union, and you're either in separation from someone or you haven't met them yet. And the divine is literally keeping it that blocked or whatever from coming in because of this right here, of the stagnancy. They need you to move. They need you to lift yourself up, and it's time to fly. Okay. And like when you start doing that and you align with that and you crush that or whatever, heal that, then this will come through like that. Okay. So let me just clarify that real fast. Okay. So you guys aren't like, okay, well, no, I'm just kidding. Erica just talking out her booty. No, I'm just kidding. But you guys know everything I say is always for a reason because I'm channeling right now. I'm channeling. Look, see, I just, look, I split the deck. There he is. Boom. And I, as soon as I split the deck, I heard Mr. Right. Mr. Right. You guys ever watch Sex in the City? Mr. Big? It's your Mr. Big. But that's the King of Cups, right? He's the King of Emotions, love, as I'm talking about love and your soulmate, your true counterpart, all right? The divine is wanting you to, you know, there's no more messing around. You know, they are wanting us to rise up, to expand, and be expansive in all ways, right? Like no more keeping ourselves small. It's like aligning with our true energy and magic and power, which is limitless, which is infinite, and it's super strong. So, right? So they are like urging everyone to follow this energy. See, look, Three of Wands, ships coming in. So I wanted to clarify that, right? I wanted to clarify that. Look at, boom. There it is. I wanted to clarify for you guys, you know, this energy that I'm feeling for this group, I guess I would say to group right at this point, even though, right, you guys are all here. This is ships coming in. So like I said, look at the wheel. I said everything I said about the Wheel of Fortune over here, but I said that it was separate from this energy, okay? The lost in space and need and direction energy, because the you guys over here that have been like doing all this already, and you guys have been ascending, and you like have been building yourselves up. You've maybe started businesses, or maybe you've ascended in your career or your job. You're thriving. You're, you know, you're goal oriented. You're Empress energy. You're all these things, right? The wheel is already turning in your favor. You're already, this is what you're receiving now. Okay. But anyways, I wanted to clarify, you know, the counterpart true love coming back in, after you move out of this energy. And this proves that because it's your ships coming in, right? So, and then obviously this confirms it as well, okay? It's about, you know, you learn some type of karmic lesson, you clear it, and boom, the wheel turns for you. And then destiny arrives, and your finances change, and luck changes, and abundance, and everything, right? This is also balance between light and dark energies, right? All right, so let's talk about this other energy over here for you guys, this other group now. All right, so the Beloved card should be over here. Let me put these back in. Okay. So someone is very curious about you here. A magician energy. I'm also feeling like you got, yeah, look, immediately we got a big fat yes. Archangel Michael's sword of truth showing up, Ace of Swords, Tower moment. Wow, the divine is sending in a lot of beautiful divine change. They're also protecting you guys in big ways. That's for everybody here. That's for everybody here, okay? This proves my point exactly. We have a queen and the Eight of Pentacles because you guys have been extremely focused. This is literally confirming everything I just said for even this group, and right? Because you guys have been very focused and, you know, all the things, right? So this is about you found your light within, your creativity, your creative sparks. You took action on it because she's action. She's all the things, right? You've been planting eight seeds, or for about 8 months working very diligently, or whatever. Maybe the last 8 months of your life has been very transformative, right? There's been a lot of changes here, okay? The divine brought in lightning bolts for you, but these lightning bolts crashed down and hit you, right? And you guys too, this other group, you guys have gotten that as well, okay? But because remember, you guys had this big crown activation activity going on over here too, but And that's what spirit's going. We need you to align because you're activated, you right, and like blah 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 blah, right? So, anyways, so someone is very focused on you, but you guys are receiving all like abundance at this point because of all of the seeds that you've planted. You took your power back in a big way. You feel good, you look good. Queen of Wands, that's all Queen of Wands. Let's see here. The Lovers, there it is. Boom. I told you. Oh my God, I love it. And then I literally, did I not say a magician energy? Off of this stranger card right here, it reminds me of the magician, specifically in the Light Seer's deck, because you'll see they're both sitting next to a pool. See? But it says curiosity. But I said you're dealing with a magician type energy, divine masculine, someone who is very heavily manifesting you. Look at that. Boom. But this is about a new beginning. The Magician is card number one, and he's showing up right with the Lovers. Okay, Gemini energy. Beautiful. So again, this confirms everything that I was channeling about you are, all these cards just fell on the ground, and I'm gonna wrap this up, my loves, is you're in this receiving mode at this point, super Empress energy, super high vibrational, super abundant. And the wheel's turning in your favor. I mean, I don't know what else there is to say. It's crazy. All right. Someone who ran returns, okay? Also, this is if you have any like lingering like bad thoughts, like shadow thoughts, like from the past, or you know, maybe you are thinking too much about the future things and things like that, right? Spirit's like, just run from that, right? I feel like this is also you guys literally like seeing, okay, through deceptive behaviors. You saw maybe through this person's deceptive behavior, this masculine energy, but this is what's coming in. Someone wants to work on this. This is that blessing. Look at who showed up again. There he is. There he is. And for you guys over here, this is the person who's waiting. Like literally, like it's like right there. That's what I'm getting. So whatever you feel like you've been needing to take more action on or heal or whatever it is, that's what it's time for, right? Especially during this Libra season. It's beautiful. Absolutely beautiful, right? Okay. The moon is in a waning phase right now, right? We just had the full moon. Waning is all about releasing, right? It's about that release. So I highly suggest if you feel like that part resonates, you write down or do your release work, write down what you want to release. Do it with this, right? Like, you know, just as a suggestion. But anyways, look at, you're showing up as the Empress. See, so this just shows that this is what you're receiving. You're in a mode of receiving, okay? All right, everything is being magnetized to you because you're high vibrational and abundant. A Lover, you know, just passion, love, drive, you know, just things like that, right? Oops. And where is it? I don't know, where is it? And abundance. Again, I talked all about the eights, eight, eight, eights, eights, right? And then look, eight, see? Abundance, it's what you're receiving. Divine inheritance, abundance is all the seeds you've planted. You've been focused, you were driven, you, right? I'm hearing not sidetracked, you, right? You worked on your craft. That's what this is, working on your craft, right? Some of you guys could work with herbs. You can make candles. Maybe you make like sage bundles, stuff like that. Stay tuned. I'll be doing my crystal shop and all the things, and you guys can, we'll be able to purchase online, but you know, like metaphysical bundles and things like that. You guys probably remember if you've been following me from like last year, like a year ago, I said, I was talking about all that, right? But I just didn't do it because, you know, spirit wouldn't want me to be doing it then because I had to work and dive into the channel, which I'm always obviously going to be doing that. But now I'm in a place where I'm even more expansive, right? So I'm ready to expand. I've been even farther out, right? So stay tuned, my loves. But anyways, you'll be able to buy like, you know, like sage and just different stuff like that. But anyways, some of you guys may do this. Some of you guys may do that. Maybe you have an Etsy shop. Maybe you make candles, or, you know, maybe you make, I don't know, right? But that's what I'm getting. Okay. So let me go ahead and wrap this up real quick with an overall. All right, spirit, give me a message for this collective. Thank you. I'm hearing I can't live if living is without you. I can't live. I can't live. So there's definitely this like divine love that's just like, just, you know, again, looming right around the corner, or either right now, right here for you guys, right? I feel the ancestors showing up very heavily right now. Actually, they want me to switch decks because they have a message. Okay. I'm going to use this one real quick from the ancestors, please. What did you want to say, ancestors? It's like we're calling on you very heavily. We're calling on you very heavily. We are with you very heavily at this time because we are guiding you into new directions. We are guiding you into new beginnings, new opportunities. We are heavily assisting you in self-love. We are heavily assisting you in the way of helping you see your worth and value. If you are undervaluing, we're helping you see your worth and value. It's like that. See? You can't make it up. You can't make it up. It's Mom Lambo. It's a beautiful card. Card number 24 breaks down to a 6. Okay? You could be a life path number 6. Be born on the 6th. Maybe we do have like this, you know, Gemini right here. Maybe you're, that's a 6 month, right? It says self-sabotage. Okay. Sacred lust on the bottom of the deck. You have a very sacred sexual bond and union with someone here. Ancestors, what messages do you have? Ooh. Oh. Worthiness. See, I'm telling you, you guys, you can't make it up. They're guiding you to see. I just told you, I just channeled out what I was hearing. They are guiding you to see your light even more so than you already do, right? To see your worthiness, to see how maybe you're undervaluing yourself, all right? Or maybe you're, right, supervaluing yourself, right? And it's other people that don't see your worth or your worthiness, right? Either way, look at etheric cords. See, there's cord cutting that needs to happen here. And there's release work that needs to happen here as well. 27 breaks down to a 9. That is the end of a cycle. Beautiful. Erzuli Dantor, etheric cords. And then your divine lineage. See, the whole reason why I switched over to this deck and did that real fast, it was because you guys, your divine lineage, the ancestors showed up, and here we are. Okay, and then it goes in reverse, right? Look, end of the message. Okay. All right. So let me do a Maji. So this is an oracle deck from Maji the High Priestess. She has a YouTube channel here on YouTube. Maji the High Priestess. You guys can go look her up. It's M-A-J-I, the High Priestess. She's awesome, you guys. She's psychic medium, but there's her oracle deck. So, of course, when I use any reader's oracle deck, I have to give a shout out, right? All right. Okay. And on her channel, My Loves, is where you can find this deck, like under her description box to order it. I'm going to just do this real quick. DNA upgrade and work with crystals, okay? So I literally just got to talking about like how I'm going to be doing my crystal shop and all these things, right? And then work with crystals. So some of you guys are being called, right, to work with crystals. Maybe it's like what you do for a living, right? There's people that do readings, divination with crystals, right? They work with crystals, crystal balls. Like there's crystal Reiki healing. Like there's all kinds of stuff, right, that you can do. You can use crystals for grid work. You can grid people's, you know, office buildings, homes, like, you know, I'm hearing like, right, like beauty salons. You can do, you can grid like light down into the earth, grid Pachamama. Like there's just so much you can do, right? There's a lot of light workers, but you know, I'm actually wanting to do a video on that, like some of the things that people are being called to do at this time. And that's one that's really big, is grid work, gridding the earth. We're doing that anyways, just by like standing in our divinity, you guys, and right, like we're gritting down the light, but no, it's like taking it a step way beyond and further. Atlantis, you have the gift of courage. Okay, so spirit wants you to know that You know, a lot of you guys are going to connect with Atlantis and that era and, you know, all that. But what I'm getting is like the lost city of Atlantis. So, you know, for anyone who's watching this who maybe feels like they've lost their way a little bit or they've been a little, you know, lost their direction or whatever, right? That's what I'm getting, the lost city. So it's like you have this gift of courage. Like, don't let the past hold you back, whatever, blah, 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 right? But I'm also getting like, obviously, like you guys are very powerful, okay? So it's like your ancestors, once again, your old souls, right? So they're reminding you of how powerful you are and how courageous you are and how you have these beautiful gifts and how you can do anything, right? This is also showing me that someone is coming in and they're being bold and courageous here. Hidden secrets. See? And then wake up. You guys, literally, you can't make it up. I literally said that this was a wake-up call for some. With needing direction, lost in space, and then the dust devil moving out of stagnation. That's what I said. Whoops. So hidden secrets. I feel like this is just what this ancestors have been trying to lead you and guide you in. And this is like just the message for confirmation. Okay. All right. So let's see here. What else, spirit? What else for the collective before we go? So I send you guys so much love, so much light. Sorry, I started channeling. I just started hearing like a bunch of different like places in the world, like cities. Like I heard Moscow in Russia. As soon as I said I heard Moscow in Russia, this flipped down. Are you kidding me? Underestimated. So I feel like, you know, maybe some of you guys are from there, okay? You grew up around that area or you're from Russia. I don't know. And, you know, you feel like you were heavily underestimated. But what I'm getting off of this the most is, like, it's like past life energy, okay? Where you maybe spent time in that, you know, around there or literally there, right? Something like that, right? Or in those, you know, in that area kind of a thing over by those countries. But it's like you've been underestimated for a very long time and your ancestors are trying to get you to value yourself or, you know, it's like people are going to treat you the way you treat yourself kind of a thing. You know what I mean? That's what I'm kind of getting, my loves. Synchronicity. See, they're showing you all the signs, my beautiful light workers, right? They're trying to bring you back, right? See, this was trauma. Something happened here. That's why I specifically got Moscow. And I also got Israel, okay? So, and then I immediately after Israel, I got like Jesus and Yeshua, like that energy, right? I stop at light worker again, right? See what we stop on one more time. What? Not only are you a miracle, but one is on its way to you. See, my loves? I'm telling you, you guys, those of you guys who have been doing the work and you've been really focused and driven and you've been working on yourselves and building up your hearts and your life and your energy and your love and all the things, right? Judgment day for your enemies, okay? Any weapon formed against me shall not prosper, right, my loves? You are receiving miracles, okay? You are a miracle and you are receiving miracles, okay? So do not worry, my loves. This is when it's on its way. So I send you guys so much love, so much light. Thank you again. I hope you enjoyed this message. This is definitely a time of, again, divine change, expansion, growth, receiving. It's all the things, right? So it's kind of like, you know, this is the time to start creating and taking action where you are, feel like you're being guided and led into your future. So since so many of your guys' third eyes are, you know, awakening so much, you know, in that regard. So I love you guys. I thank you again. If you want to book a personal psychic session, you can find the info down below. I also offer Akashic record readings where we tap into your past lives and you get to know who you are. And it also connects to this lifetime and helps you out. Okay. Cause it's always connected in some way, shape or form. Right. What else? Oh, that's also where you can find the information to purchase one of my handmade Lemurian seed clear quartz crystal pendants, you guys. My mama Gypsy creates them all for me. And then what I do is I bless them and I infuse them. It's copper wiring and they're all going to be different. They're actual towers. So it's tied to Lemuria, ancient Lemuria, Atlantis, like all the energy, right? These are seeded and coded with information left by the ancient Lemurians, okay? I'm actually hearing ancient Lemurian mothers, okay? So I don't know. But anyways, I take them, I bless them, I infuse them with my own energy healing, Reiki. I do light language into them. I infuse them with blessings, mantras, Lord Ganesh music. I do sound bowl healing. I mean, you guys, they get charged with the moon, the sun, all the things. So 444 as I look up and I'm saying this too. So anyways, you can find it all down below. I love you and I will see you soon. Mwah.